speaking here to Muslim youth. Now, TV cameras aren't normally allowed in Lakemba Mosque, but tonight, JTV has exclusive access. Napoleon wants these young men to reject American hip-hop culture, in particular the gangster side of it that saw his friend Tupac murdered. He says he got into it when he was younger because he had little choice, and he wants this crowd to know that the big rappers are fake.
And I know they fake. When you go home and listen to their record, and you want to carry a gun, they're in a mansion. They're in mansions with air conditioners, laughing at y'all. Like, let them go buy my records and kill each other. I'm through with their life, because they rich already. We stupid enough to run around and do what they rapping about.
Come on, say it loud. Look what we handed down.
Napoleon is now a devout Muslim. He no longer raps, and he doesn't even want any of his old music to feature in this story. He's been brought to Australia by Fadi Rahman from the ICRA Youth Centre at Lidcombe because of what happened to one of the guys who trained in their gym. Bassam Shami, a boxer, was gunned down in the street and killed earlier this year.
It was very alarming to us, and we had to deal with it wisely. ICRA Youth Centre thought that it was only up to us to sort of, you know, take a real approach to this whole thing. And we said, who is more to speak to these kids rather than the people that they look up to?
Why do you think some Muslim youth do take that path?
They feel that they've been marginalised by the society at large, and therefore they try to relate to anybody else and try to identify themselves to someone, and the closest people that they find to themselves is the black Africans in America. We left them a world as cursed
and it hurts. Why do you think the young guys around here are attracted to that lifestyle?
Because they're that, what they hear kind of music, you know what I mean, that kind of music, and it just pumps them up.
Because they want to be, like, you know, known and all that. Like, they think they're big, listen to rap.
Well, a lot of kids like to be the boss, tough. I'm a gangster leader. They're known in America, if you're a gangster leader, you're big, you're hip-hop, you're well-respected.
They live the hard life, and everyone wants to try and be like them in the way that they're going to jail and stuff. Before we find world peace, we gotta
find peace in the war on the streets, my ghetto gospel. What kind of trouble did you get into yourself before you found Islam?
A bunch of trouble, man, with drugs, alcohol, womanizing, hanging with the wrong people, hanging with gang members, carrying guns, shootings. I had shootouts. I did everything you can imagine that you can do out there, man.
When we took him around the streets, he said, "Are you serious? These people are gangsters? There's no such thing." And we took him to those people who think that they're gangsters, and we sat down on, you know, in private meetings and one-on-ones as well, and he started laughing.
A lot of the youths out here in Australia seem like they have good parents, they have nice clean neighborhoods, you know, and it seems like they have a way out. You know, we in the ghettos of America, if we had another way out, we would have left. We wouldn't be running towards the criminal acts and things like that.
Napoleon has seen plenty of mindless violence. Both his parents were murdered in front of him. He's come to Australia with a message for all young men of all backgrounds. Turn your back on the culture of violence.
I saw too many people get killed. It wasn't just my mother, father got killed in front of me. I seen friends get murdered in front of me, man. I seen people get shot in front of me. I seen this stuff growing up. It wasn't just a one-time thing. I used to think this was a normal lifestyle, man.
You know, of course, growing up in the ghetto and in the city, this is what you all you know is revenge. And from what I know, it never stopped. You know, I've seen people kill one person and kill this person. It will keep going on forever.
He also wants the lessons that he learned in the ghettos about revenge to be applied to the kind of conflicts we saw in Sydney last summer.
Because sometimes people piss you off just so you can get angry and see what you're going to do. You know what I mean? So as Muslims, we're supposed to be smarter than that anyway. Way to balance. Taking revenge, would that cause more innocent people to get hurt? You know what I mean? Would that cause more Muslim women to get their scarves taken off? So you always got to think about the outcome. That's what Islam teaches us, you know?
So what did you make of what Napoleon said in that?
Well, this guy's experience, since he's from that place in America, he's come from New Jersey, was it?
Yeah, New Jersey.
Yeah. Well, you see all that and you hear about his experiences, it actually affects you. You start thinking about yourself, like, maybe what he's saying is true. Maybe, like, you don't want to get into that life. You don't want to do what he's doing.
Well, they listen to his song, "I Live a Dark Life." They like the sound of it. They get to it, get tattoos. Getting locked up, 2 years, getting outside. What? To get nothing out of it.
Do you reckon what Napoleon said in there would actually turn people around?
I reckon, yeah. It would, and like you said, you know, like, you know, Sheikh Shady, like you said, if he can do it, everyone can.